Hello, today's video is in response to a viewer request, but it's also something that I was interested in taking a look at myself, though admittedly, I probably would never have taken the time to do so if it wasn't for the request, so here we are. With regards to the Dell G5 SE5505, there has been some speculation that updates since the release have reduced the temperatures that the CPU and GPU reach, but at the expense of some performance. In today's video, I'm going to be focusing solely on the BIOS and whether the BIOS updates have impacted performance and temperatures. To do this, I'll roll back my BIOS version from 1.5.0, which happens to be the latest version at the time of writing, to the earliest version available from the Dell website, which is 1.1.1, and comparing the performance and temperatures with each BIOS version in a range of games, and then Cinebench R32. My expectations going into this were either that the BIOS would not make any difference at all to the performance, or that the performance would be improved at the expense of additional heat, given the aforementioned speculations I've seen. So, let's take a look at what I found. Kicking it off with some game benchmarks, starting with Fortnite, I found the average frame rate 1% low and 0.1% low values were all higher with the newer BIOS version. The latest BIOS presents a 10.5% increase to the average frame rate, and a not insignificant increase to the 1% low of over 41.5%. Next up is Red Dead Redemption 2, which saw a less significant increase to the average frame rate using the latest BIOS when compared to the older one, of approximately 3.5%. But this time, the 1.1% lows were actually higher with the old BIOS by about 7.7% and 2% respectively. GTA 5 saw a modest boost to the average and 1% lows of 4.8% and 4.4% using the latest BIOS. The 0.1% and 0.1% low values suggest that there was more stuttering with the newest BIOS, but I must admit that I didn't feel that in game at all. In fact, I'd say it felt like quite the opposite was true. Cyberpunk 2077 sees the biggest improvement in performance using the latest BIOS out of all of the games that I tested, with the average frame rate nearly 20% higher and the 1% low nearly 2.5 times that when tested with the old BIOS. In this instance, I could really feel the improvement in this game using the latest BIOS, in that the game felt much smoother than it did with the old BIOS. League of Legends sees a marginal improvement using the latest BIOS when compared to the oldest one. In PUBG, the frame rate was once again both increased on average and made more stable by the update to the BIOS from 1.5.0 to 1.1.1, with the average being increased by over 11% and the 1% low being increased by over 32%. Rocket League saw a small increase on the average frame rate of 4% when using the latest BIOS, but similarly to Red Dead Redemption 2, bucked the trend by actually giving better 1% and 0.1% low values using the old BIOS, with the 1% a not insignificant 20% higher with the old BIOS than with the new one. The last of the games tested is CSGO, which saw a modest average frame rate and 1% low increase using the new BIOS of 11.8%, and 5.5% respectively. On the synthetic benchmark using Cinebench R32 and with a BIOS version 1.1.1, the single core score was 1,158 compared to 1,159 with BIOS version 1.5.0, so as close as makes no difference. The multi-core score, however, is a different matter. With BIOS version 1.1.1, the multi-core score posted was 7,689, and with BIOS version 1.5.0, it was more than 4.5% higher at 8,038. I can only assume that the latest BIOS keeps the CPU somewhat cooler, allowing it to perform better for longer than BIOS version 1.1.1 allows, which brings me nicely on to the temperature comparisons. With a synthetic load, the GPU reached 90 degrees C, with BIOS version 1.1.1 installed, and 88 degrees with BIOS version 1.5.0, an improvement of 2 degrees Celsius using the latest BIOS. The CPU reached 100.3 degrees centigrade with BIOS version 1.1.1 and 100.6 with BIOS version 1.5.0. So, well within a margin of error. With a gaming load, the GPU reached 93 degrees Celsius with BIOS version 1.1.1 and 88 with 1.5.0, the latter of which is the same temperature that it reached with this BIOS version under a synthetic load. The CPU reached 103.2 degrees C while gaming with BIOS version 1.1.1 and 100 degrees with BIOS version 1.5.0 installed. In conclusion, the performance results were actually contrary to what I expected to see, in that they show that most games tested perform better to varying degrees with the latest BIOS installed than they did with the oldest version. On the other hand, the temperatures were in line with what I expected to see, given the speculation whereby the temperatures reached higher maximums with the old BIOS than they did with the new one. I can only assume that the results show that the performance was impacted by the higher temperatures that were reached when using the old BIOS. Perhaps the GPU reaching higher maximums with the old BIOS also caused the CPU to get hotter due to them both sharing the same heat pipes, which in turn could have caused the CPU to not boost as high or even to throttle. Given the results we've seen, I've already returned my BIOS to the latest version. If something really is causing a decrease in performance of this laptop since its launch, it doesn't appear to be the BIOS updates. And with that said, that's the end of this video. If you've made it this far, thank you very much for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing. Do leave a comment in the comment section. I do my best to respond to them.